Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I have come up with one more logic building problem, and the problem is you must generate a series and return the nth term in the series. So let me first explain you the problem and show my solution to this particular problem. So you will be given four inputs in which you must use the first three inputs, let us say A, B and C, and you must try to identify the series from these three inputs and how you must form the series will also be explained in the problem statement. So for this particular problem statement, you must form the series such that the gap between C and its next element, let us say D, should be same as the gap between A and B. Similarly, the gap between D and its next element, let us say E, should be the same as the gap between B and C. So this is how you must be able to generate the series using the first three inputs. As mentioned, you can just treat them as A, B, C. And then once you find the series, you must return the nth term from the series. And this nth term will be given in input 4. So the input 4 represents the n value, the term which you must return from the series. So this is what the problem statement is. One thing will be sure is whatever the first three inputs as mentioned, that is A, B, C, will be such that either in the form A greater than B greater than C or in the form A less than B less than C. The first three inputs will be of the form A greater than B greater than C or A less than B less than C. And the fourth input represents the n value for which the term you need to return. Now, here I have picked up two of the test cases. The first test case is 1, 3, 6, 17. So in this, you must make use of 1, 3, 6 and then generate the series. And then from that series, you must return the 17th term. So only these four inputs will be provided to you in the form of integer. And you are expected to return the result also in integer. That means, so you will be getting the 17th term as 41. Similarly, the second test case what I have taken is the A less than B less than C condition. So using these three inputs, you must form the series and then you should return the 14th term from that series. So that will be minus 56. So how you are going to form the series, I have already said you. So you must form the series such that the gap between C and its next element must be same as the gap between A and B. And similarly, the gap between D and E should be same as the gap between B and C. So let me show you the series. Here is the series. So example 1 series is going to be something like this. So 1, 3, 6 is given to you. And we can understand what is the gap between A and B, which is 2. So D should be in the same gap from C. So that's why you can get it as 8. And the next rule what I mentioned is the gap between D and E should be same as the gap between B and C. So here B and C gap is 3. So that's why you are able to find the fifth term, that is 11. and from there on it's going to be the same. So the pairwise gap should be same. Here the gap between 1 and 3, 2. Gap between 6 and 8, 2. Gap between 11, 13, 2. Gap between 16, 18, 2. Like this. And coming to here, that is gap between B and C, that is 3. So gap between 8 and 11, 3. Gap between 13 and 16, 3. Gap between 18 and 21, 3. So this is what the point need to be noted while generating the series. And when you write down the series, you will be able to identify the 17th term, which is 41 in this case. Similarly, the second example what I have picked up with the relation A less than B less than C. So here 5 minus 2 minus 4 are the three values provided, that is ABC. So we must start forming the rest of the terms. Here from the first two terms, it is understood that the gap is minus 7. That is why the fourth term is identified as minus 11. And fifth term should be having the gap same as the second and third term are having. That is, here minus 2 and minus 4, what is the gap? It's minus 2. So that's how we formed minus 13. And the same rule is applied for the remaining terms in the series. Again, the same rule. If you observe each pair, so here the gap is minus 7, here the gap is minus 7, here the gap is minus 7, here the gap is minus 7. And if you observe between the odd positions, here the gap is minus 2, here the gap is minus 2, here the gap is minus 2, something like this. So from this series, the 14th term is minus 56. So this is what the problem is. It's very, very simple problem. Only thing is, you just need to identify the breakpoint. Once you identify the breakpoint, it's not going to be difficult at all. And even the code which I am going to show that I have written for this particular problem is also very less lines of code. But remember the fact that you will be provided only these four inputs in integer, and you need to return the output in integer. So whatever this series you are going to generate, it's only going to be for temporary. Only term you are going to return is the nth term. So this is my code. Let me first run with both test cases and then explain the code. So here first term 1, second term 3, third term 6, and nth term 17. So there you can see 41. Let me show you the other test case with A less than B less than C condition also. So first term 5, second term minus 2, third term minus 4, value of n is 14. So you can see minus 56. Now, coming to the code, it's going to be very, very, very simple code. So, in order to make it very simple, what I have done is, as mentioned in my previous solutions also, you are not going to read these inputs. You will be getting the inputs as arguments to the function. So, you will be receiving input 1, input 2, input 3, input 4 with the function, generate nth term function. And then you have to write remaining lines of code only. So here, this is what the few lines of code that I have written in order to generate that particular nth term. So what I have done is, I have taken the first three inputs, that is ABC, into an array. So here, A array I have taken with the new int of 100, because whatever the problem I have solved, the condition was mentioned that n value is going to be less than 100. That's the reason I have created an array with size 100. You can just observe in the problem statement, what will be the n value range. Accordingly, you can create that array. And then, since I already have the first three terms in the series, I have just assigned input 1, input 2, input 3 to the first three positions to my array. That is to A of 0, A of 1, and A of 2. And then, here I have taken D for calculating the difference and I for loop variable. So D I have taken for difference calculation and I have taken for loop purpose. So here we already know that how we can find the fourth term, that is D. So the fourth term should be having the same gap that is there between A and B. So that is the reason here you can see how we are doing that. So I am just taking D, input 3 minus input 1. That is how I am finding the gap. And then here you can see that from fourth term onwards, the alternate terms are going to have the same difference, because D should have the same gap as A and B. E should have the same gap that is there between B and C. So alternate terms only are going to have the same differences. For that reason, here from fourth term to the 100th term with a step of I plus 2, I am calculating the terms. Again, from fifth term to the remaining terms, again with the same step 2, I am calculating the terms. And once we calculate the terms, it's a matter of time in order to return the nth term. So that's what I'm just doing. Since it is in my desktop, I'm using this system.out.print. When you are doing, you can just replace this particular statement with return. And we already know that n value, whatever the nth term I'm supposed to return, it is available in input 4. And since array indexes from 0, I'm just returning A of input 4 minus 1. So that is what the solution. And I have already run this on the server where it is passing through all the hidden test cases also. I hope this is already optimized. If any of you find it little lengthy and further optimization is possible, you can do post it in the comment section. That will be helpful for other fellow students also. And one more thing, I am providing the links to other logic building problem solutions also in the description box. You can just have a look at those problems also. And if you have any optimizations to those problems also, you can post it in the comment section, so that everyone can be benefited from that. So that's it for today. I'll come up with one more logic building problem in my next video. Thanks for watching.